some good strong hives going on here. That's our south hive, that's our north hive. I guess this one would be north, Alaska, North Pole. Anyway, these two hives we just extracted honey from, and you're gonna see a video about extraction and the new Vivo honey extractor we have. This hive was weak, it was a split off of this, off the north hive, and I added another super to that, and we added that super right there, and we added some bees out of that. We did that with the newspaper method, and you're gonna see a video about that as well. But right now what I wanna talk about is the hive that was right there. That's up in the barn. Let's go take a look. So what I'm about to show you is beekeeper's worst nightmare. Now I did a dumb thing, and it was really dumb. This is the hive that was in between the north and south hive that I just showed you in the video. And I left it sitting there because I couldn't get into it right away, and it was like a week or two before I got to it. And then it was like another week, and the next thing I know I was extracting honey, and before I went out to extract honey, I figured, well, let's clear that out of the way. And when I did, I opened it up, and what I saw was a real mess. And what we're going to talk today about is wax moths. So I did some research on the wax moths. Trust me, after looking in this thing, I know more about wax moths than I want to. But I want to give you some more technical information about the wax moth. We'll start with the lesser wax moth. Lesser wax moths are very common in most parts of the world, except the colder regions, aided by their spread by humans. They inhabit most of Africa, including Madagascar, Australia, Europe, perhaps some more remote regions, particularly in Greece and North America, as well as parts of the Neotropics, at least Colombia, Jamaica, Puerto Rico, and Trinidad, the Bengal region, Japan, Sri Lanka, and the Marquesas Islands, and Tahiti and French Polynesia. The larvae are the only ones that eat. The adults will not. Their diet typically consists of honey, beeswax, stored pollen, bee shell casings, and in some cases, brood. Let's move on to the greater wax moth, or the honeycomb moth. Its name is Galleria melanella, and it's the only member of the genus Galleria. It's found in most of the world, including Europe and the adjacent Eurasia, its presumed native range, as an introduced species on other continents, including North America and Australia. The adult's wingspan is 1.25 inches to 1.5 inches, that's 30 to 41 millimeters. This moth flies from May to October in the temperate parts of its range, such as Belgium and the Netherlands. The caterpillar larvae, or waxworm, feeds on the honeycomb inside the bee nest and may become pests of apiculture. They do, trust me. Less often, they are found in bumblebee and wasp nests feeding on dried figs. The larvae are commercially available. They can be used as food for the rearing of captive animals in terraria, such as geckos or predatory insects. Here's an interesting little fact, not one that I'm going to test. When fried in oil, the larvae explode and take on the shape resembling popcorn. Gross. The waxworms of the greater wax moth have been shown to be an excellent model organism for in vivo toxicology and pathogenicity, testing replacing the use of small mammals in such experiments. In genetics, they can be used to study inherited sterility. Pretty interesting. Well, now we're going to show you what's inside, and it's not pretty. When I open this, there's liable to be moths flying out all over the place. I'm going to try to catch some shots of this, so you may see another camera in the photo here. But they're going to be all over the place. Now, I tried prying this top off, and it's pretty well stuck on. And it's not propolis that's holding it on. It's the wax moth comb and webbing. So get ready for ugly, because here it comes. One other quick thing before we move on. The caterpillar stage of this, the larval stage of this, looks a lot like the small hive beetle larvae. And I'm going to try to put up some pictures in the video here to show you the difference between the two. I also have some photographs that show you the difference between the greater and the lesser wax moth, and the greater wax moth caterpillar and the small hive beetle caterpillar. So let's move on. And we've got wasps trying to get into this. They're trying to rob. There's nothing left in there, but they don't know that. He's gone. Before I get the cover off, show you a couple of things here. These right in here, that's cocoons right there. That right there is the adult wax moth. There's a cocoon down in there. See a little bit of the webbing down in there. When I get the cover off, you'll see more of that. First thing I'm going to do is crush this guy right here. Don't want that baby laying any more eggs. Now, when I open this, chances are we're going to see moths flying out of there. And frames are coming up with it. That is really stuck down there. Can you hear that ripping? That's a chicken. Yeah. Squish as many of these as we can. That is one mess. When I pull this frame out, you're going to see what's going on down in there. If I can get that frame out. Yep. Look at it. They ate all the wax in there. Now, there's all kinds of little black spots down around in here, and I'm not sure what that is. You can see it, like, over in here. That might be mouse feces. I couldn't really tell you. Kind of thin area for mice to get in. It's only like 5/8 of an inch, but they could get in there. As I pull the frames, I'm going to scrape this wax off and into a garbage can. It's going to be kind of interesting because I got wire and stuff in there. Get it out as best we can. And then this is going to sit in the sun for a little bit. And then I'll clean up the frames really well. And what I'll do with those is leave them out over winter. But I want this wax out of here. And as much of these things, oh, this is going to be one mess. I want as much of this out of here as I can. Here you can see where they started eating the wood. Not a pretty sight. You may have noticed that as I've been cleaning the frames here, some wasps flying around. So something interesting just happened. I looked down in here, and there was a wasp on a live wax moth, and it attacked it, severed its head, and flew away with the head. That's kind of interesting stuff. There's one right now. But a little note about wax moths to end this up, because I've decided that I'm not going to keep the frames. I'm just going to get the wax out, bust it up, kill as much of the stuff in there that I can, and burn the frames. It would be foolish for me to try to put these back into another hive and potentially destroy that hive, so we're not even take that chance, you know, for the $20 worth of frames I've got here. It's just not worth it. Wax moths will attack a weak colony, and a weak colony can't defend itself. There's just not enough bees to do that. There were some bees in this hive, but not enough to defend it, obviously, because this is what happened. So I guess lesson learned is manage your hives and just pay attention to what's going on in your apiary, because this was not good, and this was potentially damaging to the other three hives. So I have to pay a lot more attention. I learned a lesson here, and I hope you've learned something too. Having said that, thanks for watching Clean Slate Farm. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.